Hello everyone. In this video tutorial, we'll see how to program Potassium Kit on any semi-automated biochemistry analyzer. Please note that in this video, we are using the kit manufactured by Anamol Laboratories Private Limited. Now, whatever information is required to program the software has been mentioned in the instructions for use by the manufacturer. Using this information, you can program any semi-automated biochemistry analyzer. Let's see how you can do it. The first thing that needs to be done is switch on the instrument and come to the main menu. Once you are at the main menu, select Test Operations and then select Add New Test. Here, multiple options are available to select the mode. Here, we have to select Endpoint Mode because potassium is an endpoint parameter. Now, as you can see, there are multiple information that needs to be added over here. The first information that needs to be added is the name of the test. Here, you can add any name which is suitable according to your laboratory settings. In this video, we are adding POT as the name of the test. Once you have added the name, press Enter and come back to the home screen. The next information that needs to be added is of primary wavelength. Now, this information can be seen in the instructions for use, where the manufacturer clearly mentions at what wavelength the absorbance needs to be taken. So now you have to select the option of primary wavelength and then select filter 1. From the list, select the wavelength which is mentioned in the instructions for use and then press escape to come back to the home screen. The next information that needs to be added is of secondary wavelength. Now, because the manufacturer has not given any information about secondary wavelength, you can leave this option blank. The next information that needs to be added is of temperature or flow cell temperature. Again, this information can be seen in the instructions for use, where the manufacturer clearly mentions at what temperature the absorbance needs to be taken. Now, because in this case, the default temperature which is mentioned is 37 degrees Celsius, we can leave this option and go to the next option. The next information that needs to be added is of KF or kinetic factor, which is to be maintained at 1.0. The next information that needs to be added is of volume or aspiration volume. Now, aspiration volume can be maintained at 500 microliters, or if you are doing the entire test in 500 microliters, then the aspiration volume can be reduced to 400 microliters. The next information that needs to be added is of units. To check what unit you have to enter into the software, refer to the unit mentioned in the standard concentration in the instructions for use. Whatever unit is mentioned in the standard concentration, same unit needs to be added to the software. So now we will select the option of units, and from the list we will select the units which is mentioned in the instructions for use. The next information that needs to be added is of lag time and read time, which is to be left blank because potassium is an endpoint parameter. Please note that in many instruments the option of lag time and read time will not be there because you are entering the information in the endpoint mode. The next information that needs to be added is of blank, whether reagent is to be used for blanking or distilled water is used for blanking. Again, this information can be seen in the instructions for use, where the manufacturer clearly mentions whether reagent or distilled water is to be used for blanking. Now, because in this case reagent is used for blanking, we will select the option of blank and then select option yes. The next information that needs to be added is of QC or quality control. If you are running any quality control SIRA, the value of normal or abnormal range can be entered over here. The next information that needs to be added is of normal values. Now, normal values the laboratory has to establish on its own, but if the laboratory has not established its normal values, you can enter the normal values as per the instructions for use under the column of reference values. You can enter the lowest and the highest values, which is mentioned according to the instructions for use. To do this, select the option of normal value and then select option yes. And first select the low range and enter the numerical value, which is mentioned in the lowest range as per the instructions for use. And then select enter. Next, select the option high and enter the highest numerical value mentioned in the instructions for use. And then press enter and come back to the home screen by pressing the escape button. The next information that needs to be added is of standard, whether the standard is available in the kit or not, and if yes, what is the concentration of standard. Again, this information can be seen in the instructions for use, where the manufacturer clearly mentions if the standard is available in the kit, and if yes, what is the concentration of standard. So now we will select the option of standard and then select option yes. Next, we have to enter the concentration of standard. To do this, first select standard number and then select option 1, because only one standard is available in the kit. So now, as you can see, the option to enter the standard concentration is now open. Here we will enter the numerical value of the standard which is mentioned in the instructions for use and press enter and escape to come back to the home screen. The next information that needs to be added is of limit settings or reagent linearity limit. Again, this information can be seen in the instructions for use, where the manufacturer clearly mentions what is the linearity of the kit. So again, we need to select the option of reagent linearity and then enter the numerical value which is mentioned in the instructions for use and press enter and escape to come back to the home screen. So now, whatever information is required to program the software has been entered into the software. So now we can select option save. To view the test, select the option of list test and go to the window where our program has been saved. Now, in this case, our program has been saved on option number 87. To enter the program, select it. If you wish to run any patient sample, select the option Run, and further the instrument will guide you how to take the absorbance. Thank you, and we hope this video has been helpful for you.